Hey everyone, we're at Super D USA 2018. I hope you enjoy the video. Miki Takagi's car. So behind me, we have the cars for Team Burst, or Pink Style, Naoki Nakamura and Mitsuyoshi from Japan. Obviously they're S13s and they're donning their signature purple and pink style that they're known for. This one's Nishio's car. All gunned up pretty. Check out the sparkle on the paint job right here. Can't wait to see these guys kill it on the track. Donning his pink color and the green wheels that he's known for. Even got himself on the hood right here. All the necessary styles that drifting comes with. You look pretty at the beginning of the day, then you start getting banged up as you continue to drive. So that's Naoki's style, and we're gonna see him banging doors today, getting door to door, and showing the Americans how Japanese style drifting is about.
Oh,
better as Dabsedan. Better as Super D. So how do you like Super D right now, man?
It's an amazing event. We're live here. It's really chill. It's laid back. Tons of seat time. Everybody's just sending it.
How do you like the California scene?
It's awesome. You guys have a ton more events out here. It seems like between Grange, Adams, and the little balcony, there's like three events a week. It's incredible. And all the like companies are out here. There's so much more networking. It's an amazing scene out here for sure.
Absolutely. Like right now, especially for being a sedan community type driver, you're like one of the heads right now leading the pack. So why the sedan? Why the sedan?
Sedans, when I first got into drifting, it was all about style. And seeing these guys in these big body cars just swinging and throwing it around, and it was just more exciting and more stylish to me. I never cared so much about the performance per se. And then when I found out kind of the cost of making some of those sedans a reality, it was too much.
Yeah.
Nowadays, with the availability of the G35 and the parts availability of the 350Z, as far as a US available sedan, there's nothing better out there.
Because I
can import a chaser, but then you bang a door or crack your windshield, you can't get a single part. And you'd also get one factory available with a manual. Aside from aero, some company, please make aero.
Please make aero for our G35s.
There's enough dudes out there. We need aero for G sedans. I'll help however I can.
We're out there. It's just that, you know, we don't have much style options. We want to be like Nobuken. We want to be like Nobuken, right? Yes. The original four-door Skyline.
Make some purist, even a KB rep. I don't care what you have to do. Just make some kind of dope drift influence aero for sedans. The car's gonna take off. Absolutely.
Somebody, you know, we're so like, kind of like distorted in how to get into drifting that we always get discouraged, like new people especially get discouraged after seeing all these ridiculous builds, thinking that I can't do this because I can't afford that. But is that necessarily true? Like, we all started at the grassroots with nothing, right?
What happened was I started off in bone stocks and KMK, and back in the day that's what everybody did. It was the beginning of drifting, nobody really cared, there was no final bound, there was no hype over hot boy and all this stuff.
Yeah.
That didn't exist. So at the time, it was very acceptable. When I got back into drifting in like 2010, 11, that was there. That kind of style was like apparent. And it wasn't just like the top guys that had it. Every car had to have it. So at the time, I started building an S14. It had the RB. It had all this stuff.
All
I started
goodies.
Overbuilding. And I got out to a couple events. And it wasn't as fun. And it was just constantly replacing stuff. This is actually what motivated me to buy the G35 in the first place. A stock G35. You need a couple simple modifications. You can learn to drive, get tons of seat time, not have overheating issues.
Yes.
You can still drive it. You can get that crappy car out of the driveway. Like, you can have a nice car, and yeah, you get respect still in it. And like, a couple little things, fully capable. You can hang with any car out here with a simple stock G35.
And any like other advice for like beginning drivers that want to start doing drifting, like?
Don't be afraid of being the new guy in spinning, because all of us have been the new guy in spun.
Yeah,
you gotta try, you get over your fears, and all of a sudden you're like, oh, I'm not gonna get hurt, or the car's not gonna be totaled if I just spin out, things like that. Nobody's gonna like remember that I suck. And like, if you quit at the beginning because of that, like, you never get the respect. If you get through that little learning curve, it's longer and shorter for some people. You'll get through it, and it's gonna feel so much more, and everybody around you is gonna like, guy. So just show up to events, because all of us have been that new guy, and we know what it means to have the heart to keep coming, and you're going to gain the respect of everybody if you just keep putting in the time, and they see you fixing your car, they see you out there driving. That's all you got to do, just have heart for it.
Just heart for passion.
Don't try to be a hot boy, don't try to be cool, don't try to like do whatever, just go out there and drive.
Stay humble.
Yeah, don't act like, ask advice of the elders, like don't act like you got your stuff together, there's always something you can learn. And you're gonna vibe with everybody as long as you're coming in open-minded and suggestions and everything. It goes a long way. Absolutely.
That's great advice, Alex. Thank you so much for the interview, man. It's great seeing you here.
Excellent.
Glad you like the California, style.
Absolutely.